This video is brought to you by Storyblocks.
Hey guys, it's Jordy here for Cinecom.net. Welcome to Copy Get Friday, where we recreate effects from films and music videos. Today, we are having a look at Nigahiga with his latest music video, Exposed. So, let's do this.
Hello, people from the interwebs. Today, we are having a look at Nigahiga and his latest work, which is a music video called Exposed. We can see this pretty cool scene in which these words are kind of part of this scene and this camera is kind of like doing these cool movements around him. There is also a behind the scenes video in which we can see the entire set and the equipment and all of that. So we recreated that set in here, and later down the video, we're also going to show you how to recreate the actual effect. But first, we need to pay attention to some things before shooting. In the music video, they had this treasure chest laying on the floor and they put some lights in there so that it would shine up from the bottom. We don't have a treasure chest, but we do have this LED panel from Aperture with a soft filter over it so that we have some lighting coming from the bottom. Then over there, we've got a backlight which sits more on the side, and over there we've got another backlight which actually sits in the back. And that's the only thing that you're gonna need, and of course also a black wall. Now, for the effect to work, you don't need to have this specific lighting setup and all. What is important though are the tracking marks. Throw it to me, Janik. We're going to use some simple tape for that. This right here is the wall behind us. We're just gonna need structure. Now, if you are working with a plain black wall in a dark environment, you're not really going to see the structure of the wall. So that's where tracking marks comes in. Now, we are just going to use some normal white tape and just stick that to the wall, and that way we have some contrast, we can see them very well, and these are going to function as tracking marks, which we're definitely going to need once we're going to jump into After Effects in order to make the effect work. So just add a few of them, also here one on the bottom perhaps. I'm gonna stick one more over there and one over here, and that way we've got four tracking marks. I'm going to stand in the middle, and that way we've got them here beautifully on the side. Then have someone take a gimbal while you just stand on your spot in front of that lighting on the floor, and that person is just going to make these gimbal movements from the left to the right. You can go pretty fast, you can also go up and down, sideways, and all of that. Now guys, you don't need a gimbal in order to pull off this effect. You can also go perfectly handheld. It works the exact same way inside Adobe After Effects, which I'm also going to explain to you.
I made the effect in After Effects. Let me do it.
Okay, Janik, but first, I'm going to thank the sponsor of today's video, which is Storyblocks Video. With Storyblocks Video, you've got unlimited access to 4K high-quality stock clips, After Effects templates, backgrounds, transitions, and so much more. And the cool thing is that you only have to pay a single price per year, and that's it. It's really cool. We use it very often on our project as well. Definitely make sure to check it out. You can do so by clicking the first link in the description below. And now, Janik, you can go ahead and explain the After Effects stuff.
So guys, let me explain this cool effect to you. In After Effects, you load in your shot of your talent and drag it into a new composition. Select this layer and go to the tracker panel and choose the track camera option. It can take a while sometimes, but let it do its thing. When it's done, select a few points on your talent's face. Right click on it and select create a null and camera option. This will create a 3D camera layer and a null object. This virtual camera represents the actual camera movement we have done in the studio, which is going to help us place the text within the environment. Now it's time to make the floating text. Take the type tool and type a part of your text. A keyword, anything you like. First, we are going to make the text layer a 3D layer. By doing this, the text layer can be placed in the 3D space. Now that this is possible, search for the moment you start a movement. Let your text layer start from here and place the text where you want. Because of the 3D camera, it looks like the text moves in and out. But we are going to emphasize this even more with a small animation. So in the beginning, place your text off screen. Try to take into account the movement you are making and where your end position of your text is. For example, our movement is from the left to the right, and the end position of the text is on the right side. So the begin position of our text is on the right side off screen. Enable the animation for the position and go further in time to where your movement stops and let your text move into the screen. Then go further to where your next movement starts, create a keyframe with the same value as the previous one, and then move even further to the middle of your movement and drag your text off screen again. Of course, don't forget to smooth out your keyframes. You can do this by right-clicking on the keyframe, select Keyframe Assistant, and ease out for the begin keyframes, or ease in for the end keyframes. And now you have a text that moves in and out in sync with your movements. Next, we are going to add a glow to the text. So in the effects and presets library, search for glow. Drag that to your layer and play around with the settings. You can go for a heavy glow or a subtle one. We went for something in between. For the glow colors, you can set it to A and B colors. Then choose the color of the glow you want on the bottom of the effect. We chose the same color for both A and B, something yellowish. Then we are again going to search in the effects and presets panel, but this time for a gradient ramp effect. Drag that to your text layer and in the effect control panel, choose the start color, which for us is white, and the end color, again something yellowish. After you have picked your colors, you need to place the start and the end of the ramp. Place the start ramp above your text and the end ramp underneath the text. But because we animated our text, we also have to animate the start and the end ramp. So place the playhead on the same spot as the position keyframes we already made, and create keyframes for the start and the end ramp. Always keep the start ramp above the text and the end ramp underneath. The next effect we are going to add are the Venetian blinds. This effect will provide horizontal lines, which will give this VHS look. In the effects control panel, set the transition to 20% and the direction to 90 degrees. For the width we took 6, but this depends on the size of your text. Also, feather it a little. We are almost there, but there are just 3 more details you can add. The first one is a typewriter effect that they did. This is easily created without an effect from the library. Just expand your layer properties and search for the text drop-down option. To the right of that, you see animate and a small icon. Click on this icon and select opacity. This will create an animator, and within this you find the range selector option and opacity. Set the opacity to 0 and open the range selector. Here you can set the end to 100 and the start to 60%. Now enable the animation for the start and go further in time to the middle of your text layer. Then set your start to 100%. After you have done this, open the advanced dropdown and here you want to set your smoothness to 0. Now your text comes in letter by letter. The second thing we now have to do is the glitch on the text. For this we need to create an adjustment layer. So go to the layer menu on top, choose new and adjustment layer. Trim it smaller so that it covers your text partially. Also make this a 3D layer. Now position it on top of your text and create a mask. You can find the pen tool on top in your toolbar or you can press the G button. Just create a small horizontal rectangle that covers part of the text. After this it's time for the glitch effect. Go to your effects and presets panel and search for the turbulent displacement effect. Drag that to your layer and in the effects control panel, you can change the displacement to horizontal displacement. Set the playhead to the beginning of the adjustment layer and change the amount to 0 and the size to 2. Then enable the animation for the amount, size and evolution. Go a few frames further in time and set the amount to 400 and the size to 3. Then go almost to the end of the layer and create a keyframe for the amount and size with the same value as before. However, now you can change the evolution a lot, to around 4 turns. Now go to the end of the layer and change everything back. So the amount back to 0, the size to 2, and the evolution also to 0. The next thing you need to do now is get rid of the tracking marks in the background. This we are going to do with a mask on the original footage. Select the clip from your talent and the pen tool. Start at the beginning of your clip and create a rough mask around the talent. Open up the properties of the clip and then open up the mask property. Right-click on your mask 1 and choose Track Mask. This will open up a tracker window on the right side. For the method, select Perspective and start the tracking. Always keep your mouse on the stop button so you can intervene when necessary. Now that this is done, go back to the mask properties and feather the mask a bunch. And if the mask is too close to your talent, expand it a little. The problem we now have is that everything around the talent is black, even the backlights. But we still want them in our shot. And that is why we are going to create a second mask on this layer. Create a mask with a U-shape. Go to the mask properties and enable the animation for the mask path. Go further in time and adjust the mask so that the backlights have come in and out. And that was it! For at least one text layer. You now need to do this multiple times for different text layers and then you will get this very cool effect. Very cool indeed and perfect for your next diss track or music video. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you Storyblocks for the support. But like always, stay creative.
Thank you.
This right here is the wall behind. What am I gonna do? Gah! Oh, like, oh, Yannick, stop me, dear. Off!